Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is the presentation for the nervous tissue, the first lecture. In this lecture, we are aiming to define the nervous tissue, to list the divisions of this nervous tissue or nervous system, and to define the neuron, describe the structure of the neuron, and describe the classification of the neurons. First of all, what is the nervous tissue? Nervous tissue, it is the tissue responsible for four functions, formed of two systems, and having two types of cells. What are the four functions? First of all, it is responsible for receiving stimuli and an integration of these stimuli with their analysis. Integrate the stimuli and analyze the stimuli, and then we'll give the response. So we have receive, integrate, analyze, and respond. Here the stimuli are received by the afferent sensory neurons, and these impulses will be integrated with other neurons, and at the same time are analyzed to give the proper response through the effector neuron to give the response. Actually, the receive, respond are carried out by the peripheral nervous system, while integration and analysis is carried out by the central nervous system. So we have two systems, peripheral nervous system and central nervous system. Also, we have two main types of cells. We have the neuron. The neurons are larger in size, but they are very less in number compared to the other type of the cells. The other types of the cells are the neuroglia. They are the servants for the neuron. They are smaller, but very more in number. There is the ratio between the nerve cell number and the neuroglial cell number. Here it is 1 to 10, 1 for the nervous cells and 10 times for the neuroglial cells. Let's start by the neuron. The neuron is the structural and functional unit in this nervous tissue, and their number is more than 10 million. So imagine what is the number of the neuroglial cells. The structure of the neuron is a very common question, short question. It is formed of cell body and processes, dendrites and axon. We will start by the cell body. The cell body has another name, which is perikaryon. Peri means around, karyon means the nucleus. So this is the perikaryon or the cell body. This part is responsible for receiving stimuli, and it contains nucleus and cytoplasm. So it is responsible for receiving the stimuli, and it is formed of nucleus and cytoplasm. What is the description of the perikaryon alone? It's also a short question, very important. We have to comment on four points: the size and shape, nucleus and cytoplasm. Let's start by the size. The size is very variable, from very small to very large. The 4 micrometer, it is the size of the granular cells. Here are the granular cells, these cells here, dark spots here in the cerebellum. While the size of 100 micrometer is present in motor neurons, either in the spinal cord, this is motor neuron, or in the cerebral cortex. Take care, cerebellar, it is the example for the presence of the small cells like the granular cells. Cerebrum, it is an example for the presence of larger cells, which are the motor neuron pyramidal cells present in the cerebrum, as well as the motor neurons, which are the anterior horn cells present in the spinal cord. So again, we have here the larger cells, motor neurons present in the cerebral cortex, and here we have the granular cells. Here, these dots, these dark small dots here, are the granular cells present in the cerebellum. Now, as regards to the shape, first we have commented on the size, and then we will comment on the shape. As regards the shape, we have 3 main shapes. We have globular, we have fusiform, and we have multipolar. As regards the globular, it is the cell which more or less rounded, and it has one process, T-shaped process. This side of the T is responsible for receiving impulses, and then the efferent impulses will pass through the other side of the transverse process of the T. So it has one pole from which arises this T-shaped process. This one is very characteristic for the cells in the spinal ganglion. And then the multipolar, and then we have the bipolar, where we have two poles. One pole for receiving impulses and another pole for giving these impulses away as an efferent impulses. So this is the bipolar and or the fusiform. And then we have, as regards the shape, we have the multipolar, where we have a lot of poles like this one, and this one also it is multipolar, and this one also is multipolar. Now, what is the difference between these three multipolar in the shape of the pericardium? Here the shape is pyramidal, and this is stellate like a star, and this is pyriform like a vase. So as regards the shape, we have globular with one pole, unipolar, bipolar, fusiform with two poles, it is called bipolar, and multipolar, either pyramidal or stellate or pyriform. Number three, in the comment on the pericardium, we'll comment on the nucleus. The nucleus has four features. It is very large. Look for the space occupied by this nucleus in this nerve cell. It is a huge area occupied by the nucleus, so it is very large. And it is more or less spherical. More or less, it is spherical. And it is achromatic, because you can see it is very vesicular, meaning here we have the chromatin of the extended type, means that it is very active cell. And as long as it is very pale, the nucleolus is very evident. So we have large, rounded or spherical, and it is achromatic, meaning that it is very pale, and as long as it is very pale, it has a very prominent, evident nucleolus. What is the meaning of these two last features? It means that it is a highly active nucleus, highly active nucleus. Then, as regards the cytoplasm, we have five organelles and three inclusions. The five organelles are the rough endoplasmic reticulum with the secretory, which is the Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, neurofilaments, and microtubules. We don't have centrioles except in some young neuron cells. We may find the centrioles. As regards the inclusions, we have melanin, lipofuscin, and lipid. Let's now see what about these organelles and inclusions. As regards the organelles, we have here rough endoplasmic reticulum and its secretory, which is the Golgi apparatus. We have microtubules and the neurofilaments, and we have the mitochondria. So we will study them, as these two are related to each other, these two are related to each other, and finally we have the mitochondria. Let's start by the rough endoplasmic reticulum, together with the free ribosomes, either in the form of single ribosomes or aggregated free ribosomes called polysomes. Explain why there are a lot of them. Of course, this appearance of a lot of rough ER polysomes and single free ribosomes denote that the cell is performing a synthesis process for a lot of proteins. And these proteins, either for the export or for the needs of the cell inside. So for the export, they mean as the rough endoplasmic reticulum, as an example, neurotransmitter. For the need of the cell, it is the function of the free ribosomes, either single or polysomes, as an example, membrane proteins. So we have here the appearance of the rough, the polysomes, the free ribosomes. Actually, Nissl found these basophilic granules in the light microscope in the cytoplasm of the neuron. He named these granules according to his name, Nessel granules, and after the electron microscope, we found that these granules are actually some aggregates of parts of the rough ER, polysomes and free ribosomes, free single ribosomes. So these Nessel granules are actually formed of three components. They are actually very, very basophilic, and the number depends on the type of the neuron and the functional state. When it is exhausted cell, the Nessel granules will be much less in number. When it is highly active, it will be in huge number. And also according to the type of the neuron, according to their functions also. Here, what is the significance of the presence of a lot of Nessel granules? It's an indication for the high protein synthetic activity of the cell, either for the export or for the needs of the cell. On a cell export, the neurotransmitter for the needs of the cell membrane proteins. Here, the second organelle, which is the Golgi apparatus, the secretary of the rough ER, and may be asked, what is the importance of the presence of well-developed Golgi? Here, the Golgi will appear around the nucleus in the form of a network. Here, the function of the Golgi, it is the concentration and packing of the protein delivered by the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So, it is an indication of high synthetic activity of protein, especially the proteins for the export outside of the cell as the chemical transmitters. Then we have the third organelle, which is the mitochondria, and they are scattered throughout the cytoplasm. What is the importance for the energy release? What is the function of this energy? It is needed for the synthetic activity. Any synthesis process needs energy. And also it is needed for the transmission of the nerve impulse. So this is the correlation between the structure and the function. Then we have the neurofilaments. Actually, the neurofilaments, they are the intermediate filaments, 10 nanometer in diameter. And they can be seen by the electron microscope. These are the neurofilaments. During preparation of the sections for the light microscope, some aggregation takes place for these neurofilaments, and the size increases markedly from 10 nanometer to 2 micrometer. Take care, micrometer. Okay? And they can be seen by the silver stain by the light microscope. Here we have to change their name slightly. They are called neurofibrils. So the neurofilaments, which are seen by the electron microscope, are the neurofibrils seen by the light microscope stained by silver after some aggregation of them together with each other, accumulation with each other, and acquire a larger diameter from 10 nanometer, they will be 2 micrometer. Don't forget the micrometer equals 1000 nanometer. Then, what is the significance? This is the correlation. What is the significance of these neurofibrils here for the nerve cell? It is present actually in the body and in the processes. So it is responsible for the structural support, to support these structures, either the pericardium or the processes. Then we have the last organelle to describe. It is the microtubules. The microtubules are these tubes, which is 20 to 22 nanometer. Take care of the difference in the sizes between the microtubules and the neurofilaments or the neurofibrils. Here they are responsible for the transport, and they are running parallel, present also in the pericardium and the processes, and they are responsible for transport. Transport of what? Chemical transmitters or enzymes from place to place inside the cell. Here we have the last part in the description of the cytoplasm, which is the inclusions, stored material. Here we have three inclusions to be remembered. The lipofuscin. The lipofuscin, it is an inclusion resulting from accumulation of waste products. And they acquire this myelinated appearance, circles inside each other. and they are increasing with old age. The more we are older in age, the more we accumulate waste products in the nervous cells. Also, we have the melanin. The lipofuscin is golden brown, the melanin is black or brown according to its density, and it is a normal component in certain cells present in the midbrain called substantia nigra, nigra coming from black. And thirdly, we have the store for the energy in the cell, which is the lipid. It appears in the electron microscope as these electron lucent vesicles. Then, here we will now return again to the structure of the neuron. We have said that the neuron is the perikaryon, which have been discussed before, and we have processes. The processes are two types. We have these dendrites and we have these axons. Now try to make a comparison between the dendrites and the axon, which is very easy question here as regards the number. The dendrites are numerous, but the axon is always single. The dendrites are short, but the axon is very long. The dendrites are thicker than the axon. The dendrites are branching like the tree, but take care, the branches are arising at acute angle. They are arising at acute angle from each other. Here we have the branching arising at acute angle. It's a branching here arising at acute angle. But the axon, it arises to form a right angle with the pericardium. Here, not branching except in two situations. It is branched at the end and sometimes it gives collaterals. So this is the branching only in the axon, while in the dendrites are always branching and the branches arises at acute angle. Here it is branched only at the end and sometimes collaterals appear in the form of a right angle to the long axis of this axon. Here dendrites are thinner as they subdivide. Here the thick, but by the subdivision it becomes thinner. Like in here, it is a uniform constant diameter all through. The dendrites contain the nacelle granules, but the axon is devoid completely from the nacelle granules. Both of the dendrites and axon, they are containing three common structures: mitochondria, neurofilaments, and microtubules. يعني دايما التلاتة دول in the dendrites and the axon. Mitochondria for the energy, neurofilaments for the support, microtubule for the transport. Describe the classification of neurons according to three ways: according to the shape, which is the polarity, according to the function, and according to the length. As regards the shape, we have mentioned before that we have three types according to the shape: the unipolar, the bipolar, and multipolar. Where we can find the unipolar? We can find the unipolar in the spinal ganglion. When we can find the bipolar? We will find them in the eye, in the nose, and in the ear. Where we find the multipolar? We find them, as we have said, in the anterior horn cells of the spinal cord, in the cerebral cortex, and in the cerebellar cortex, as we will see now. Here we have the unipolar present in the spinal ganglion. And here we have the bipolar, two poles, which is fusiform in shape, and it is present in three situations in your body. And the multipolar stellate in anterior horn cells and sympathetic ganglia. The pyramidal will be present in the cerebral cortex and the piriform in the cerebellar cortex. Now, start by the unipolar. This is present in the dorsal root ganglia and in the dorsal root ganglia, which is the spinal ganglia, and also in another situation in the trigeminal nucleus, which is called mesencephalic nucleus. Here, the dorsal root ganglia or the spinal ganglia, we have here the unipolar, which is globular in shape, and here this is the nucleus of the trigeminal. The trigeminal nerve has four nuclei. One of these nuclei is present in the midbrain called mesencephalic nucleus. The cells in the mesencephalic nucleus here are of the unipolar type. So this is the mesencephalic nucleus of the trigeminal nerve. Then we have the bipolar, which has two poles and fusiform in shape. This type of neurons is present in three situations, and all of the situations are in your head. It is present in the bipolar nerve cells in the retina. It is present in the bipolar nerve cells in two ganglia in the ear, one for hearing and the other for equilibrium. For hearing, it is called cochlear. For equilibrium, it is called vestibular. And lastly, it is present in the olfactory mucosa. Here we have the multipolar, which is stellate, like a star. This is present in the anterior horn cells as well as in the sympathetic ganglia. So remember that here we have multipolar stellate in the sympathetic, while the spinal has the globular unipolar. Here we can see the picture of the stellate multipolar, many poles, and it looks like a star. This type is present in the anterior horn cells and as well as in the sympathetic ganglia. Then we have another type of multipolar, which is the multipolar pyramidal. The shape is pyramidal. It has many poles. This is present in the cerebral cortex. Here it is present. Then we have the last type of the multipolar, which looks like a vase. It is the multipolar pyriform, which is present in the cerebellum. So this is the pyramidal in cerebrum, and this is the pyriform multipolar called Purkinje cell. Present where? Present in the cerebellum. Look here, we have the granular cells present in the cerebellar cortex, and they were as an example for the small cells 4 micrometer in diameter. So we have in the cerebellum, we have two mentions for two cells, the granular 4 micrometer in diameter and the pyriform multipolar called the Purkinje, present as an example for one of the multipolar cells. Here we have the classification according to the function. We have finished according to the shape. Now the function is a very easy classification. We have sensory neurons, and we have motor neurons, and we have intermediate or relay neurons. These intermediate or relay neurons, they are present only in the central nervous system, like this relay neuron present in the gray matter of the spinal cord, carrying the impulse from the sensory to the motor. Then we have the lens, classification according to the lens. We have very long and we have short. The Golgi type 1 is the long one, and the Golgi type 2 is the short one. The Golgi type 1 has long axis, and it leaves the gray matter and passes to the white matter. And they are present in the cerebral cortex and the cerebellar cortex and the spinal cord. يبقى ده التلاتة locations بتاعتهم. هما عبارة عن cells معينة present in the cerebral cortex. زي مين؟ زي pyramidal cells in the cerebral cortex. The axon should pass for a long distance to reach the anterior horn cells in the spinal cord. And also we have the Purkinje cells. Purkinje cells اللي احنا خدناها example for the pyriform multipolar. It is present in the cerebellum. Also they have a long axon, so they are related to the Golgi type 1 of neuron according to the length of the axon. They leave the gray matter in the cerebellum and passes to the white matter. Also we have the motor neuron in the spinal cord, anterior horn cell. They leave the gray matter and pass in the white matter and form the part of the spinal nerve. So these are the Golgi type of long axon. The Golgi type 2, it is the type of short axon. They originate in the gray matter and terminate in the gray matter. They never reach the white matter. So they have short axon, which does not leave the gray matter and never enter the white matter. الاكزامبل بتاعتهم نفس الاكزامبلز اللي خدناهم في الجولجي تايب 1. They are present in the cerebral cortex, cerebellar cortex, and also in the spinal cord. يبقى الريلي نيورون ده من نوع الجولجي تايب 2. يبقى الجولجي تايب 1 البودي is present in the gray matter and the axon arise passes in the gray matter and leave it to reach the white matter. Present in the pyramidal cells in the cerebral cortex, in the Purkinje cells in the cerebellum and also in motor neurons of the motor neurons of the spinal cord. And the Golgi type 2, it is present in the same three locations in the cerebellar cortex and in the spinal cord and in the cerebral cortex, cerebellum, cerebrum and spinal cord. Thank you very much.